Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 6.1. So here we are going to discuss the design procedure of the helical gear using the PSG data book. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the spur gear design and we solved problems on the spur gear design. And here we discuss the helical gear in this lecture. The learning outcome to the lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to design the helical gear using the PSG design data book. Helical gear has the teeth in the form of helix around the gear. Two such a gear may be used to connect two parallel shafts in the place of spur gear. The helix may be right-handed on one gear and left-handed on another gear. There are two types of helical gear, a simple helical gear or a single helical gear. The second one is herringbone gear, which is double helical gear. And we will discuss the gear terminology. So this is the formation of gear tooth on the surface of the cylindrical, on the cylinder. So the angle is alpha, helix angle is alpha. We have the PC and the PN. We will define various terminology. Helix angle alpha, it is constant angle made by helices with the axis of rotation. And this is how the helical gear is rotating. Comparing with the spur gear, these gears are gradually engaging from one end of the gear to the other end. And the helix, the gear teeth are cut in the, with an angle, helix angle. You can see the incline, the surface, the helix, the teeth is inclined to the axis of the gear. And the axial pitch, PC, it is distance parallel to the axis between similar faces of the adjacent teeth. It is the same as the circular pitch and it is therefore denoted by PC. So axial pitch is equal to circular pitch. The distance between the adjacent gears. The axial pitch may also be defined as the circular pitch in the plane of rotation or diameter plane. So the circular pitch is very much similar to the spur gear. Now the normal pitch, so it is distance between the similar faces of adjacent teeth along the helix on the pitch cylinder normal to the teeth. So along the helical angle we measure the pitch distance, the distance between adjacent teeth, that is called as normal pitch. It is denoted by PN. The normal pitch may also be defined as the circular pitch on the normal plane, which is the plane perpendicular to the teeth. Mathematically, normal pitch equal to PN equal to PC into cos alpha. PC is the axial pitch or the diameter pitch, and the alpha is the helix angle. And the various forces on the helical gear. In helical gear, the contact between mating teeth is gradual, as we have seen in the diagram, starting at one end and moving along the teeth, so that at any instant the line of contact runs diagonally across the teeth. So the strength of the helical gear is determined by the modified Lewis equation. The Lewis equation already we have discussed in the spur gear. The strength of the gear tooth Fs is given by sigma b within square bracket, that is the design bending stress. So b is the face width, y is the form factor, pi into m, m is the module. And the dynamic load on the gear, helical gear, is given by Fd equal to Ft into 21V into b cos, bc cos square alpha plus Ft cos alpha divided by 21V square root of bc cos square alpha plus Ft, where c is the velocity factor, p is the pitch rein velocity, Ft is the tangential force, which is calculated by power in kilowatt divided by the pitch rein velocity. The wear load on the helical gear, the load due to the wear, which is given by BDQK divided by cos square alpha, where B is the face width already we have defined, D is the pitch diameter of the pinion, Q is the ratio factor, and K is the load stress factor. And we discussed the design procedure of the helical gear using the PSG data book. So, there are two types of problem in the design of any gear. One is as per the procedure given by the PSG data book and using the Lewis equation or the force Buckingham equation, the dynamic load given by the Buckingham equation. Generally, majority of the problem we have to solve using the PSG data book. So, from the definition of the problem, find the speed ratio. The speed ratio is equal to number of teeth on the gear divided by number of teeth on the pinion, which is Z2 by Z1, or it is also equal to speed of the pinion divided by the speed of the gear, N1 by N2. The equations are very much similar to the spur gear. And if the value is not given, we have to assume 1. And we take the material. So, you take the material for the gear and the pinion from the PSG design data book, table number 5, page number 8.4. And the table is shown here, table number 5. Depending on the speed ratio, you select the material for the pinion and the wheel. Then we take the properties of the material from the data book if the properties are not given. Then select the tooth profile and the pressure angle. Generally, we take involute profile with the pressure angle 14.5 or 20 degree. So, unless it is mentioned, it is mentioned in the problem, it is up to the designer to select the pressure angle. So, 14.5 or 20 degree. Then we calculate the torque, that is the twisting moment to be transmitted or the force to be transmitted by the gear. So, Mt equal to 97,420 into power in kilowatt divided by N1, where N1 is the pinion speed. So, Mt torque is in kilogram force centimeter. Then we calculate the design torque, where the design torque Mt within square bracket equal to Mt into KKD. So, KKD is a K is the load concentration factor, which is available in the table number 14, and KD is the dynamic load factor, which is available in the table number 15. And initially for our calculation, we do not know any parameter to dimensions of the gear for selecting the dynamic load factor, the load concentration factor. So, we take 1.3 initially for our calculation, KKD equal to 1.3. So, this is the K value, load concentration factor, depending on the face width and diameter of the pinion. And this is the dynamic load factor depending on the quality and the surface hardness of the gear. So, these two will be using later for checking. Initially, we take KKD equal to 1.3. Then we take the equivalent Young's modulus, and this is available in the table number 9, page number 8.14. You can directly select the equivalent Young's modulus depending on the material of the gear. E1 is the Young's modulus of the pinion material and E2 is the Young's modulus of the gear material. And the table number 9 is here available. So, steel, suppose if you have steel, so both are made by steel, any steel, alloy steel, carbon steel, you can take 2.15 in 10 power 6. If it is combination of steel, cast iron, you can select the appropriate value. Normally, bronze nylons are not given, so will be given either steel or cast iron. Depending on the material, you select the equivalent X modulus. Then we calculate psi equal to B by A, face width divided by center distance. Again, we do not know face width or the center distance, so initially we take between 0.5 and 0.8 for our calculation. Then you calculate the design surface compressive stress, sigma C within bracket, CB, HB, KCL, or you can use CR, HRC, KCL, where CB, CR are the coefficients available in the table number 16, page number 8.16. HB is the Brinell hardness number, HRC is the Rockwell hardness number, and KCL is the life factor, which is there in the table 17 of page number 8.17. So, this is the CBCR value, table number 16, depending on the material and type of the heat treatment and the surface hardness, you can select the value of HRC, CBCR and the HRC value, HB value. Then this is the life factor. So, life factor KCL depends on the number of cycles, life and number of cycles and surface hardness depending on. So life in number of cycles, you have to assume, if it is not given, you have to assume greater than 10 power 7. And if it is given, you have to calculate the life in number of cycles. Then you calculate the center distance. A is greater than or equal to I plus R minus 1. So plus 1 for external gearing and minus 1 for internal gearing. Cubic root of 0.7 divided by design compressive stress whole square into A into design torque MT divided by I into psi. So this will be in centimeter. And we calculate the design bending stress. So the equation is available. And the parameters, design bending stress, 1.4 KBL divided by N into K sigma into sigma minus 1, where KBL is the life factor for bending, table number 22, it is available. K sigma is the stress concentration factor, table number 21, it is available. N is the factor of safety from table number 20, and sigma minus 1 is the endurance limit from table number 19. So, all these tables are shown here. So, this is table number 19 for endurance stress. So, depending on the type of gear, forged steel, cast steel, alloy steel, cast iron. So, we have two the equation, sigma u and sigma y. Sigma u is the ultimate tensile strength and sigma y is the yield strength. So, you have to take the properties from the data book. Unless if it is not given in the problem, then you have to calculate the endurance stress. Then, this is the factor of safety. Depending on the material, mode of manufacture and type of heat treatment. So, specify, you give the specification and based on the specification, you select the factor of safety. Then we take the stress concentration factor which depends on addendum modification coefficient x value. Normally, you take the value in the middle column, x value is less than or equal to 0.1 greater than 0. Then we take the life factor for bending, it is again depends on the life in number of cycles. KBL. So, life in number of cycle, if it is not given, you can assume life is greater than 10 power 7 cycles per number of cycles. Then we take the number of teeth on the pinion, Z1 equal to 14 to 20 initially, calculate the virtual number of teeth, ZB equal to Z1 divided by cos cube beta, so where beta is the helix angle, so 8 to 25 for helical gear, 25 to 40 for the herringbone gear. Then determine the minimum normal module. So, normal module is greater than or equal to 1.15 cos beta into cubic root of design torque divided by design bending stress YV psi m Z1, where Z1 is the number of teeth on the pinion. YV is the form factor depending on the virtual number of teeth, table number 40, page number 8.53, and psi m again we have to assume as 10. So, this is the form factor table, table number 40, depending on the number of teeth, virtual number of teeth, you have to take 14.5, 20 degree full depth and stub teeth. So, depending on that, you have to select the YV value. Then, we take psi m equal to 10 initially. Then, we calculate the module and take the nearest standard module from table number 1, page number 8.2. I show the table in the next slide. Then, calculate the module, m equal to mn divided by cos beta. Calculate the axial pitch, PA equal to pi into MN divided by sin beta. Determine the number of teeth in the pinion, Z1 equal to 2A by I plus 1 into M. And calculate the number of teeth in the gear, Z2 equal to I into Z1. And this is the table 1 for taking the module value. So, prefer choice number 1, choice number 2. Mostly you try to take choice number 1. If the number is not available, then you go to the choice number 2. Then we calculate the diameter of the dimensions of the gear, PCD of the gear, PCD of the pinion, D1 equal to M into Z1 centimeter, PCD of the gear D2 equal to M into Z2 centimeter, center distance A equal to D1 plus D2 divided by 2, and we calculate the face width, so B equal to psi into A or psi M into M or 1.15 into axial pitch. So whichever is higher among the three values, whichever is higher, we have to fix that as the face width of the helical gear. Then we have to check our calculation. For checking, first we have to calculate the pitch line velocity V equal to pi D1 N divided by 60. Then we take the KKD and calculate the design torque. So, KKD value from the table already we have shown here and you have to select the KKD value and then calculate the design torque. Then check for the compressive stress. So, sigma C equal to 0.7. I plus R minus 1 divided by A into square root of I plus R minus 1 E into MT divided by I into B. The value should be less than or equal to the design compressive stress. If the condition is not satisfied, change the phase width B. Then check for the bending stress. For helical gears, sigma B equal to 0.7 I plus R minus 1 divided by A MN B into YV into MT. So design torque. And this value again should be less than or equal to the design bending stress what we calculated earlier. And the herringbone gear, sigma B equal to 0.85 I plus R minus 1 divided by A MN B into YV into design torque, which should be less than or equal to design bending stress. If the condition is not satisfied, change the face width. Then check for the plastic deformation. And normally in our design calculation, unless it is mentioned, we need not do the plastic deformation, because for a student, we have to solve the entire problem in 20 to 30 minutes. So, if it is plastic deformation is also included, so it will take more time. So, normally in our calculation, we check with the design, check with the design bending stress. Then all the value required for MT maximum, sigma C maximum, sigma B maximum, everything is available in the table number 24 and 25 in page number 8.21. So, these are all the tables for taking sigma C maximum and sigma B maximum in kilogram force per centimeter square. Then check the, calculate the dimensions of the gear. So, addendum FO into M, where FO is 1 for full depth teeth and 0.8 for stub teeth. Majority of the cases we design only full depth teeth. Redundum FO plus C into M, where C is the clearance factor, 0.25 for full depth teeth and 0.3 for stub teeth. Tooth height is addendum plus dedendum, and tip circ diameter for both pinion and gear, use the formula PCD plus 2 into addendum. So, then we have to write down the design details, all the design details you have to write. So, this is the design procedure that you have to follow for designing the gear. So, strictly follow the procedure, use the calculators carefully, take the data carefully from the data book, and calculate all the parameter, and finally you present the data. And these are all the books I have published earlier in mechanical engineering, and I upload the video lectures on the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel for your better learning, and thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. So if you have any queries, you contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. We'll meet again in another video lecture with the problem solving on the helical gear design.